All right, you have 7 weeks until the holidays. How are you going to pay for it? It's time to start planning so you don't begin the new year with a debt hangover. What if I told you you could be on the way to saving $1,000 by the holidays? You can, and I'm not going to tell you that old standard make your own gifts. This is real money, and the biggest savings comes from your house, your mortgage. Refinance if you can. Lower a 6% mortgage on, say, a $200,000 loan. Lower it down to 4.2%. You're going to save $221 a month. You can also save money when you ditch your gym membership. Throw on a pair of running shoes. You could be saving $120 if you either cancel or you just put your gym membership on hold until after the holidays. And some gyms will let you do that. Also, you need to be really smart about how you're shopping for groceries. Don't buy your groceries ever at the drugstore. A recent study of the basics purchased at some Boston drugstores shows they cost as much as 50% more than at a grocery store. You could be saving, on average, $25 a week if you avoid buying any grocery items in a pinch at the pharmacy. And, you know, be smart. Buy in bulk. Don't buy name brands all the time. You can also go to discounters. Also, never use an out-of-network ATM. If you do this twice a week, you're spending more on bank fees than you do on fresh vegetables. Walk the extra block, drive the extra mile. You're going to save $50 easy by the time the holidays roll around. Also, you want to check and make sure you're using your technology in a smart way. Bundle your internet, your phone, your cable. You can save, I don't know, $60 a month if you switch from paying for them all separately and shop around. And finally, this one's so controversial, but maybe you should be making your coffee at home. You could be spending as little as $15 a month instead of, you know, $2 a day on your cup of joe. If you add it all up, here you go. And you can pick and choose what's right for you, but that's $1,000 in savings right there. The National Retail Federation says the average person's going to shell out about $700 on presents this year, so you could pocket that extra $300 or so for your savings. Christine Romans, CNN, New York.